Great start. Welcome. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas to you. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas.
Welcome tonight.
We welcome you in the name of the Lord. God bless you. Thank you for the effort to come out tonight. And I'm so thankful that we're here in person. Also, a special welcome to those who are joining us by live stream tonight. So, Merry Christmas to you and God bless you as well. And we're so thankful for tonight's special concert. A very special hello tonight to the residents of Oliver House who are also joining us by live stream. We got a long, long relationship with Oliver House, and they're viewing us tonight by live stream, and the grade 8s have visited them one time, and we're going to visit them again. We're still going to host them for a Christmas party. It's going to have to be delayed to the new year because they're actually still dealing with COVID. But I'm thankful that we're not, and we're here live in person for a Christmas concert. Praise God. So, can you all help me say Merry Christmas, Oliver House, on the count of three? One, two, three. Merry Christmas, Oliver House! Nice to meet you. It's also my pleasure to introduce to you former BCS students, BCS mom, and a director of Calvin Campus in our own church, Andrea Gradley, this year for a meeting. Andrea.
Kennedy Road Church's Caledon campus, and we operate every Sunday morning right here in this room at 10:30 a.m. And for those of you who may be new to BCS, BCS is an extension of KRT Ministries. And so on behalf of our lead pastor, Pastor Brian Como, and all of our leadership team, we just want to wish you all a Merry Christmas. We pray that you would know God's love for you this Christmas, and that you will experience His presence in a personal way. I also just want to take this opportunity to invite you to join us for one of our Christmas Eve services. I've got tickets here tonight. They're completely free. It's really just has the information for you. It's a reminder and also a good tool for you to invite your family and friends to join you. We are having a service right here at 10:30 on Sunday, December the 24th in the morning, as well as 9 o'clock and noon at our Kennedy Road campus. So we hope, if you're not already connected with a Bible-believing church in the community, that you will make this part of your Christmas celebration. Our kids' choir singing, our adult choir singing. It's going to be an awesome time to celebrate Jesus' birth. But before we turn it back over to our amazing students as they worship the Lord with the talents He's given them tonight, let's say a quick word of prayer. God, I just want to thank you so much for every single person who is here tonight, every single family who is part of the BCS community, God. I thank you that not one of them is here by accident. Every single one is important, and you have a plan and a purpose for their life. So God, we just invite you to come and have your way in our midst tonight. I pray that you would be glorified in everything that takes place. I pray that you would calm any anxious nerves of our students and use them to bring glory to your name tonight, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen.
Than the world can show, for Christmas bringeth Jesus, brought for us so low. Earth, strike up your music, birds that sing and bells that ring. Heaven hath answering music for all angels soon to sing. Earth, put on your whitest bridal robe of spotless snow, for Christmas bringeth Jesus, brought for us so low.
can't you see I'm sleeping? I don't care if you're sleeping. Wake up!
Whatever it is, it better be important.
Zeph, look, there's an angel here, and I think he wants to talk with us.
An angel? Wow, Jethro, you do need more sleep.
Look, look.
Wait, Jethro, look, there's an angel.
Told you there was an angel.
Oh, I'm sorry, Jethro. It's just that this sort of thing doesn't happen every night out here.
Okay, be quiet. Let's listen to them.
I know we get loud winds, wolves, strange noises, and sometimes I get dreams, but this is an angel.
Okay, enough already. Let's listen to them.
Fear not. The mighty dragon has seized your troubled minds. Glad tidings of great joy I bring to you, the humankind.
Hey, Jethro. You've been around here longer than I have. When you go to the synagogue, you know. Has this ever happened to you before?
No, it hasn't, though. And I don't know where to make of it either, but I think this is more than just about you and me getting our sleep.
You sure did that, though. Hey, what do you suppose this angel means by glad tidings of great joy and to us in humankind?
How am I supposed to know? Let's just stop trying to figure it out and listen to it.
To you in David's town today is born of David's line, a savior who is Christ the Lord, and this shall be his son.
David's town. Bethlehem! That's just down the hill from here!
Oh, sleepy little Bethlehem. They're pretty full these days with census and all. It is Zeph, and something wonderful has happened there. A savior, tonight, Christ, our Messiah, is born!
We don't get so many of those in Bethlehem, do we, Jethro?
No, we don't, Zeph. Not that we don't want one. Our people have been waiting for a Messiah for hundreds of years. And now, if the angel's right, he's been born. Right here.
Well, what do you think we should do?
For now, let's just sit and listen.
The heavenly babe you there shall find, to human view displayed, all meaningly wrapped in swaddling bands, and in a manger is laid.
What do we do now, Jethro?
Honestly, I can hardly think for myself. What do you think? Go to Bethlehem.
Well, what about the sheep? And it's the middle of the night.
Don't be so practical, man. This is a message from God about the Messiah being born down the street from us. Honestly, man, that is as thick as a ram's. This is prophecy. This is poetry. This is faith. This is salvation, man. You could write a song about this.
You're right. Come on, let's go.
Travel light and fast. I said light.
You don't need your suit, sir.
Oh, okay.
Right, let's go.
Do you know the way?
No, but we have a GPS.
A GPS?
Yep, a global positioning star.
Are we there yet?
No.
Are we there yet?
No.
What about
now?
No.
Now?
No! Jerusalem, at last. Now, where would one find the king?
Where would one find the king?
One would presume in a palace.
Who goes there?
We've come to see the king.
Do you have an appointment with his majesty?
Well, no.
We've come to see the baby.
The new king!
Well, I'm sure his majesty is hugely pleased to learn of the new king. Our dungeons are full of people looking for to be the new king. Are you looking to join them?
No, but the azimuth of Jupiter, it declines the Martian orbit.
The zenith of Venus.
The big shiny thing.
It's a new king.
Come to think of it, there were three blokes from the East here last week. Pack them up to Bethlehem, right? You should try them.
I don't believe it. I thought we'd arrived. I thought we'd found the new king.
They didn't offer us a cup of tea. How rude.
Now, we have to keep traveling to Bethlehem with you two?
Our journey will continue because it is only right that we should seek this king. A king for whom the stars shine to show the way, even that big shiny one. Many will settle on this journey, whether wise men, wise women, rich, poor, young, or old. Some will make it, and some will find the journey too difficult. So pull yourselves together and let us seek this king. Let us continue our journey to find the king who has been promised us. Let us diligently seek him.
What?
I didn't even know he knew such big words. Come on, let's go.
Come, let us seek the king. God with us, Emmanuel.
We're excited to be able to perform for you, and right now we've got the grade 6 band coming in. This is the second year we've had a group of grade 6s performing for a concert on their ukuleles. It was COVID really that forced us to switch from traditional band instruments that you've already seen the Academy band play to guitars and ukuleles for a time, and ukuleles really were just a hit and a lot of fun to play, and so we decided to stick with it. And so here we are. We've got a group of close to 60 strong, and we're excited to share some Christmas songs with you. And they're going to be doing some singing, and you know what? In the spirit of the occasion and the season, if you would like to sing along, you're welcome to as well. fun to have the ukuleles playing. I trust that you're enjoying it as well. We have a special guest for this final song, though, and I'd like to invite a grade 12 student by the name of Alina Wojciech, and she's going to be singing with the grade 6 band as they perform Silent Night. Please welcome Alina Wojciech. Okay, lots of moving parts. This is our senior high praise team, and they've been performing for different chapel events and different things this year. And you're going to get to hear a number of them featured. On piano, we have Natalie. On guitar, we have Noah. We've already heard from Marina. We have Grace, Gabby, and Maddie. And down here, she's sort of moving away, unfortunately, but Sahara is playing bass guitar.
Thank you.
as our senior high drama class is just setting up for their next performance, and our grade 7 band is making their way to the stage. I just want to share with you how proud I am, really, of their progress so far this year. This is their first year playing these instruments. They've been playing the instruments for really about 2 months, and they've just made tremendous progress. We've been having a lot of fun. To tell you a little bit about the first song, we've been learning about a few different musical terms. One of them you will know, solo. A solo is when one person plays, right? A soli, which is what you're gonna hear a lot of tonight, a soli is when a whole section plays. So that could be, say, just the trumpets, or it could be just the clarinets, or really, it could be a collection of instruments, but not the whole band. And then the last one is when the whole band plays, and that's called tutti. Yeah, tutti. So tonight, you're gonna hear some solis, and you're gonna hear a whole lot of tutti. So this is Good King Wenceslas. Thank you.
I'm just writing down all the stuff we have coming up to do. Either Christmas, or the kids' concerts, or the sporting events.
Whoa, that's a lot.
I know.
What's the other in column for?
That's my coping ideas.
Coping ideas?
Yeah, from the sermon on Sunday.
But he talked about hope.
Yeah, that's right. Cope.
No, hope, not cope.
Oh, I guess I was a little distracted. Breaking up my kids fighting, and then the youngest spilled his drink. It was a hot mess.
Well, I guess you don't need this list anymore.
Are you kidding me? Do you see how long this list is? I'm just getting overwhelmed looking at it.
Okay, okay. So what ideas do you have for the second column?
Well, I was thinking something like pounds of chocolate and gallons of coffee.
That does not seem super helpful.
Yeah, you want some coffee?
Yeah.
I know, but I'm just being honest. Throwing a few tears and that's my usual method. But I was thinking maybe adding something different, like taking a walk or bubble baths.
That does sound nice, but I'm not sure if that's really what the pastor was talking about.
What? Do you have another way to deal with all this? Sports? Family? Junior high band concerts? Look, I don't want to do anything illegal.
Well, if you think about the sermon, you should be focusing on hope.
Hope? Like, I really hope that the kid that plays the flute takes the right notes or stays home sick this year. Because I really hope that. I mean, I really, really do hope that.
Well, I feel you there. But I was talking about real hope.
I've heard this all. This is the season of hope. Hope doesn't disappoint. Blah, blah, blah.
I get how it can feel that way, but hear me out. Coping is all about you and what you can do. If I do this, then I'll be able to survive. Hope is about him and what he already did.
Okay.
Why do we call Christmas the season of hope?
Well, I don't know. We hope that we can survive it. We hope that winter won't last forever and that spring will come. We hope that our kids will like the presents we give them?
No, it's called the season of hope because of what we're celebrating. We're celebrating Jesus being born.
Okay, I understand what you're saying, but how does that get me through hours of bleacher sitting and junior high band concerts?
How can you not? You have God sitting right there next to you, listening to that joyful noise that the flute is making. It doesn't change the circumstances. It changes your heart.
I need that.
Trust me when I say this, me too.
Guess I don't need this anymore.
To paint with light. Where's the little bambino?
Ah, yes, such a lovely little one. Okay, this is just gonna be a quick shot. Look directly at the camera and say, Jesus.
Could you view the picture too? After all, this table doesn't belong to us.
We'd like our pet cow on too, if you don't mind. Could you?
Could you feel kind of jersey.
Yeah, anyways, whatever. Okay, Evelyn, just say Jesus.
Wait a minute. That looks like it's going to be a super photo. Supernatural final out on. You see, it's clear there's one thing missing. All great Christmas photos have angels on them. Now we'll wait on the wings forever now, may I?
Yes, I'm sure I'll get you ready. Okay. Everyone, let's just just say Jesus.
Hold on a second. You can't have this picture without us.
If we follow this angel all the way to the city of David, it would be nice if you could let us onto the portal. Have a souvenir.
Back with us. Otherwise, we won't sign on the believer story.
Now. What? I don't know, man, just say Jesus.
Hold on. We have a magic problem on things. Some wise men from the east want to be in photograph as well. But then the younger Hamlets can't join. They've taken the hump. Can the Hamlets be in photograph as well?
Now come get out of the photograph! Just say Jesus.
We wish you a Merry Christmas! We wish you a Merry Christmas! We wish you a Merry Christmas! And a Happy New Year!
We'll sing another Christmas carol
if
we don't land on the photograph too.
Oh my gosh, no.
To her senior high drama class, and a good reminder for us not to crowd Jesus out of Christmas. I think there's a tendency to do that sometimes, and so it's a good and slightly humorous reminder. But here we are. I wanted to introduce the next performer, and it just so happened that one day in music class, he was playing this song on the saxophone. I thought, man, that sounds good. And I said, listen, you need to play this for everybody tonight. So this is Obafemi Dulu. play the Christmas song. Now we have our junior high choir under the direction of Mrs. King, Ms. McKenzie, and Mrs. Green.
Thank you.
Beyond compare. You are my wisest confidant, the trusted guide through life and its moments of despair. Jesus, mighty God, awesome in power, author of every life story. You are my passionate creator, the purpose and grace giver, so worthy of worship and glory. Jesus, everlasting Father, timeless protector, provider forever. You are my welcoming family, the permanent refuge where I am strengthened and treasured. Jesus, Prince of Peace, abiding calm, mediator above. You are my unity with God, the final sacrifice for sins, his beacon of love. Jesus, wonderful counselor, mighty God, everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. You are my savior, the haven with heavenly names. Glory to God, the angels rejoice. Hallelujah. Yes, let there be praise.
Public speaking course, and everything just sounds better at me being a British accent. Of course, she reads wonderfully. And oh boy, one more time for our junior high choir. I feel like maybe we're going to have to start charging admission with performances like that. This is great. Well, I hope you enjoy yourself. You do have quite a full program. tonight, but we are approaching the end. This is our grade 8 band that's making their way in behind them. There's been a slight change to the program, just in that they're going to do their songs in the opposite order. So, Hymn of Thanksgiving, which they will now perform second, just by way of introduction, was a song they recently performed for our previous junior high chapel. And the tune is a sort of famous hymn, and it seemed appropriate given that we intended to perform it for our Canadian Thanksgiving, and that didn't happen, so American Thanksgiving, I guess, is just as good. But really, as we enter the Christmas season, it really is a time of Thanksgiving. We have so much to be thankful for, and even though it's not explicitly a Christmas song, I felt it was worth including in our performance tonight, because number one, we played it really well, and number two, it is a great opportunity to be reminded of just how much we have to be thankful. One more thing, sorry, I should say before we start this song, have yourself a merry little Christmas. We'll feature Isabella Zizek on trumpet. Thank you. Thank you, Great Eights. Well, it's a special season, of course, and it's been a busy season already for me. And as many of you already know, my wife and I just had a baby. That's our sweet little girl, Miracle Brielle MacArthur. She was born last Tuesday. Okay, so she's just over a week old. Yeah, there's another one. And just this morning, our firstborn, our little guy, Everett, was able to hold her for the first time. Yeah. Right? Yeah. So, yeah, I mean, pretty cool. It's an amazing thing. And so I guess I've just been reflecting this season as we enter into Christmas and we think about the birth of our Savior. And just, you know, everything that we've been through over the past 9 months, really. And what a journey it's been. And so just kind of reflecting on that and pondering on that and thinking about our Savior this season, I wanted to read a little something for you. Coronation of Jesus, perhaps the most joyful, certainly the most triumphant moment in history, second only to the resurrection. For now, the glorious kingdom will come, the eternal summer romp of men and angels. His crowning ensures the triumph of a kingdom of laughter and beauty and life forever. But it was a long and circuitous road to that throne. No king has ever taken such a humble path. His first step is a staggering descent. The Son of God becomes a son of man. This is taken from Philippians chapter 2, verses 5 to 8. It says this, "Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness. And being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient." Humbled himself. Humility hardly begins to describe the incarnation. It boggles the mind. The eternal Son of God, light of light, very God of very God, one substance with the Father, spent 9 months developing Mary's uterus. Jesus passed through her birth canal. He had to learn to walk. The Word of God had to learn to talk. He who calls the stars by name had to learn the names of everything, just as you and I did. This is a cup. Can you say cup? Cup. Or did you think that baby Jesus came into the world with the vocabulary of dictionary.com? I love that. And I'd like to finish by reading for you from the book of Isaiah, chapter 9, verses 1 to 3 and 6 to 9, which says this, "The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. You have enlarged the nation, increased their joy. They rejoice before you as the people rejoice at the harvest. For unto us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness, from that time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this." Amen. And so as we celebrate this Christmas season, I hope that it will be part of your celebration to remember this amazing birth, this amazing Savior, this incarnation, Emmanuel, God with us. And if not, I encourage you to seek out a place where you can learn more about this amazing event and this amazing hope that's been sung about and heard about this evening, and make this a part of your life. And so, thank you for being here. And with that, we'll turn it over to our Academy band for our final performance of the evening.
more thing I'd like to just like to pray for you before you leave tonight. I know some of you are going to be back next week for our elementary concert on Wednesday night, so we'll see you then. But in case I don't see you, I want to pray for you for God's blessing for you this Christmas time. Let's pray. Father, thank you for Jesus. Thank you for Jesus. Thank you for Jesus. Thank you that you love everybody here so much that you sent him. And we celebrate that this year. I ask that everybody here, Lord, everybody in our school community will experience the deep peace of Jesus this Christmas season. In your name we pray. Amen. Amen. Thanks very much, everybody.